and shot right over that chipmunk's head. Trying to sneak up on these chipmunks in the morning. Got this fowl following me around. Look at him. Come here, Hank. Come on. That dude just follows me around. Which, he ain't hurting nothing. But he's almost like a dog. That chipmunk had his head popped up over here. Check this out. Got this wood pile from this spring. He was sitting right through there. Anyway, I'm gonna get one here this morning, maybe. All the squirrels are hanging way up in the treetops and I don't want to lose any arrows today. I got a fowl out here making noise. That's great. Check the steam rolling off this stump. It's steaming. I don't know if you can see. Sun's hammering the top of that log. Pretty neat, man. Doing some yard hunting today, some practicing. Put a couple arrows there low in that buck's heart. Well, I kind of ditched Hank. I don't know if you can hear him or not. Oh shit, here he comes. Look at him, he figured out that I left. Has to keep an eye on me all the time. So I was gonna show you guys a couple modifications I've done. Well, you can call them experimentations because that's all I do. First, this is all leather. I glued that little leather strip on there for when you're stalking. You can put your arrow shaft down there and throw your finger over it instead of keeping it up on your flipper. That way you don't have any fear of like breaking your arm off of there. Then another thing I did, let's get that into the sun where you can see her. Maybe. You guys see there? There is a, you know how they come, little plastic cushion button. Call it a burger button. I cut that flush off and I'll show you how I did that. And then I glued a piece of leather on that just so it's something solid. Because what if it got cold or something and that little plastic launcher cushion button, burger button, whatever you want to call it, side plate, snapped off of there. So I did this and it's working really good. I'll show you what I did here in a little bit. I got a fowl following me around still. All right, so here's my modification that some of you guys will probably think is complete bull crap to even mess with, but I'm a bull crapper. Here's a new flipper. There's a little side plate. And I always wear them out, wear grooves right in them. See, it ain't held on there by a whole lot, but it is. I mean, it's good, but it's not. But it could be better with a piece of leather like I just did. Which, really, it's probably never, ever going to break off. Tootsie's in there eating. Better not ask her to hold this little camera for me, so we'll just come out here and do it. Vern, go out there and take you a shit, dude. Drop one. Are you kidding me? Here's that fowl again. Hank, get out of here. Get. Oh, man. I got a fowl pal. Hank, get out of here. All right, so I got to prop this up just so you can watch. So what I do, I flip it upside down. We ain't going to have a good angle. Just go right down the edge there of this thick part. The rest, use a little utility knife. Just cut that sucker off. You want to cut it off flat. I know it's hard to see, but you see how that's crooked. I'm just going to trim that up. Cut her flat. Now, yeah, I know. You guys might be watching it thinking that it's just BS. You know, sometimes I get theories and I want to bulletproof stuff. Hank, outside. Go. I don't know about this old fowl. So, I just get theories. Now check this out. So you can see the inside component there. It's on a spring, and then let me prop you back up. Like, these things will flip backwards too. Nice piece of leather on there. And I got a few flippers down here. Here's one I had on Vesper's bow, but I just put that piece of felt that comes with it on there. And I still get perfect flight. Don't worry about any of that. You just got to tune your bows, dude. Here, I set up my other Phoenix. Same way. See, and here's my... When I was telling you about whenever I'm stalking, I don't... Either you can press it up against there with your finger, or you can put it on the shelf and see when I put leather on there, it makes no sound. So on a windy day also, your bow's up there hanging, that wind ain't gonna blow your arrow off when you've got a nice piece of leather there. I'm just moving around because the lighting looks messed up, but I don't know for sure because this is a GoPro. But look, when you're stalking, you can set it below the rest and really put some good pressure there for just walking around. You know, that's all I got.